This is the installation of the 730133 inline speedometer calibrator. Today we're going to be installing it on a 2023 Jeep Wrangler. It goes from 2018 JL through all the JLs and the Gladiators. First thing you do is disconnect the battery. With all the stop-start vehicles, they have a secondary battery, and you have to remove this one. This is a 13 millimeter bolt. This one is 10. We remove this one first from here, and then remove the whole cable. You got to keep them separate, or it'll continue to power it. All right, I'll walk you through what we're going to do. It sounds horrendous, but it's not. We remove this, the bezel, this piece of trim, which allows us access to the instrument cluster bezel, which eventually allows us access to the instrument cluster itself. We also have to remove down here the kick panel. It's all super simple, takes about 20 minutes. First, we'll remove this piece. Basically, you just gently pry, and it just pops off. It's held in with several clips. And on the back, you have two connectors. Push the top, pull gently, not on the wires. Push the top, pull gently, probably with both hands. And set it aside. Now you have two bolts that hold on the radio bezel. Right here. The only real tool you'll need is a Phillips screwdriver. It is held in place with lots of tabs. Set it aside. This piece of trim is held in place with one screw and more than enough tabs. We do not have to remove the radio. Starting at one end, you pull backwards toward the rear of the vehicle. And place it out of the way. A kick panel. All pops off. But the next piece, which is this boot around the steering column, is held on by two bolts here and here. Flashlight might come in handy. Oh. Now, we're going to go ahead and remove the instrument cluster bezel. Four bolts across the top, here, 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 and here. You might want to lower the steering column to make it a little easier. Again, lots of clips. Pull gently. Now, we are at the instrument cluster. You have bolts on all four corners, and that's all standing between you and being halfway through the installation. Slides straight out. Connectors on the back, tabs on the bottom. Pull gently. Now, when you're installing it, first configure it using the configuration software. Download it over the internet from our website. Go ahead and connect the black connector in. This one just goes in line between this connector. Note the tabs are on the same side. Everything should square up and look nice. And then on this one, same thing. Make sure it pops and connects. I recommend a zip tie so that it holds the two together. Now, because the Jeep is so close to the front, there isn't a whole lot of space to shove this, place this. And it does present somewhat of a problem. At this point, we recommend that you put some bolts in to hold the instrument cluster in place, and that you replace this piece and take it for a short test drive and verify that your speedometer is correct before replacing all the panels. Now that we've done the final test, we will replace all the panels in the reverse order, and that completes our installation.